Hello everyone, welcome to MSFT Webcast. In this video guide, we will see the steps to create a file server cluster with Windows Server 2019. In the previous video, we have seen the steps on how to set up a Windows failover cluster with Windows Server 2019. If you haven't seen that video, then go back and check out that video first. Link to that video is also given in the description area. We are going to use our existing failover cluster to build file server cluster. Before we can start with the file server cluster configuration, the file server role must be installed on all nodes which are participating in failover cluster. This is our first node with the host name ws2k19-sav02, and on this server, we are going to install file server role first. For that, I am going to click on Manage and let's click on Add Roles and Features. On Before You Begin screen, we need to click on Next. Select Role Based or Feature Based Installation and then click on Next. First, select our host ws2k19-sav02. Click on Next. Expand File and Storage Services. Expand File and iSCSI Services. And select a File Server. Click on Next. Next again. And click on Install to start the installation process. Perfect. Installation is completed on our SRV02. Now it's time to install file server role on SRV03 as well. Let's click on Close to close this console. Let's again click on Manage and select Add Roles and Features. Click on Next. Next again. And this time we need to select our second node, which is WS2K19-SRV03. Click on Next. Expand File and Storage Services. And then expand File and iSCSI Services. Select File Server role. Click on Next. Next again. And click on Install. Okay, installation is completed on our SRV03 as well. Let's click on Close to close this console. After installing File Server role on both nodes, now we are ready to start configuration of File Server cluster role. For that, we need to open Failover Cluster Manager. Let's click on Tools and click on Failover Cluster Manager. Once you open Failover Cluster Manager, expand your cluster, which is mylab cluster.mylab.local in our case. Then we need to click on Rules. If you have any existing role configured on your Failover cluster, that role will be listed here. Let's right click on Rules and select Configure Role. On Before You Begin screen, we need to click on Next. Select the role which you want to configure for high availability. In this video, we are going to use a file server role. So let's select file server. If you haven't installed file server role on any of your node which are participating in failover cluster, that time you are going to get an error at this screen. Once you select server role, click on Next. We will create a file server for general use as we plan to host file shares for end user. And that's why I'm going to select file server for general use. You can also select a scale out file server for application data as per your requirement. Once you select file server type, then click on Next. In this step, we will define how clients can access the file server cluster. Type a name for your file server cluster and assign an IP address to the cluster as well. For the purpose of this video, I'm assigning a name mylab-fs01. Let's click here to assign an IP address as well. Already 172.18.72 is written there. Let's specify IP address 11 to our file server cluster. Once you provide cluster name and IP address, then click on Next. Now it is asking us to select the storage for file server, where a file server role is going to store its data. We have only one disk available on our cluster and that we are going to select. Once you select your storage, then click on Next. Confirm the settings which you have selected, like network name will be mylab-fs01, IP address will be 172.18.72.11, and it is going to create one client access computer object inside the Active Directory under computers container. And we are going to use cluster disk 1 as a storage. Click on Next. Perfect. First server cluster has been created successfully. Let's click on finish to close this console. After we finish the wizard, we can see the file server role up and running in Failover Cluster Manager. And here we can see owner node information is also there, and that is WS2K19-SRV02, which is currently hosting this file server cluster. Also, a new computer account is also automatically created in Active Directory for file server cluster with a new DNS host entry associated with that account as well. Let's check them out on our domain controller. On our DC, first of all, I'm going to open Active Directory Users and Computers Snap-in. Under Computers Container, you can verify MyLab-FS01 computer account is there, and under Description, you can verify Failover Cluster Virtual Network NEM account. If you want to separate these cluster accounts from your existing computer account objects, that time you can also create a separate OU to store your Failover Cluster Virtual NEM accounts. Let's right click on mylab.local, click on new and select new OU. Here I'm giving name cluster computer account. Click on OK. Let's click on computers container. Select both computer account, right click on it and select move. Let's click on cluster computer account container and click on OK. Let's click on cluster computer account OU. And you can verify that computer accounts are stored under this OU. Fine. Let's check DNS entry as well. For that, I'm going to click on Server Manager. Let's click on Tools and click on DNS. Let's expand for lookup zones. And let's click on mylab.local DNS zone. And you can verify that DNS entry for mylab-FS01. This is a host record associated with IP address 172.18.72.11. Let's again go back to our node SRV02. After creating a file server cluster, now it's time to create file shares for end users. And for that, I'm going to right click on mylab-FS01. And here we have an option to add a file share. We will select the SMB share quick profile as we plan a general purpose file server for end user. Once you select file share profile as per your requirement, click on next. Select the server and path to create a new share. As you can see, under server name, mylab-FS01 is listed, and under share location, you can see only volume M is listed with the size of 100 GB capacity because we have only attached one disk for our file server cluster. Let's select the radio button, type a custom path, click on browse. Select volume M and under it, I'm going to create a new folder. Let's give name share1 and select the folder. So path will be M:\share1. Click on next. If you want to add description for your share folder, that time you can mention that information here. Click on next. Next again. We also want to keep the default permissions because this is just an example. Let's click on next and click on create. Perfect. A new share folder is created successfully. Let's click on close to close this console. And let's access that share folder from our domain controller for the testing purpose. Let's go to our domain controller. Let's press Windows R key. Type uncpath mylab-FS01 and press enter key. And you can see a share one is there. Let's access it. And let's create one new folder under it. Let's give name admin. And perfect. So as we can see, we have successfully accessed that share folder which we have created on our file server cluster. And that's it for this video. Thank you all for watching this video on how to create a file server cluster with Windows Server 2019.